public comment. This time we'll take public comment on items that appear on today's agenda. Speakers will be limited to 2 minutes. We ask that you begin your comments by identifying yourself and the agenda item that you wish to address. I've got three people signed up. It is Jacobson. Mia Jacobson, Samuel Bellameo, and then Alex Zimmerman. Mia.
Thank you.
Welcome back.
Thanks. Nice to see you guys. Good afternoon. I'm here today as a part of Stand Up America because I have no other opportunity to address you as a full council in a public arena, according to our own concerns, the concerns of the people. This generation has lost faith in the government because you will not listen to us. And you talk behind closed doors where there is no opportunity for accountability and no chance for an opposing view to reveal a compromise or coordination of efforts. You control the conversation. And quite frankly, if we as a community are to weather the storm that is in front of us, this cannot continue. The process and protocol in place has led us to where we are today, and this must change. We must come together as a people and figure out what we are going to do differently. An open meeting once a month with no preset agenda will allow this conversation to happen. This is essential as we prepare for the future. And if you disagree with us, please start the conversation by telling us why.
Complete?
Mm-hmm.
Great. Sam?
Are you going to tell me why you don't agree?
So this is a public comment period.
Were you listening to what I was saying?
I was absolutely listening. So if you're finished, I need to move on to the next person.
Well, I asked you a question at the end of it.
If you're finished, I need you to make way for the next person.
45
seconds more. Okay. Yeah, I still have. Well, can you tell me why you don't think this is a good idea?
It's a great debate tactic, and some people try that because you try to pose.
It's not a tactic. It is actually a debate tactic
because you're trying to pose the most extreme version of what you're saying, and I hear you.
It's not very extreme.
I've also been really clear, and you know, we have this conversation at the committee level, at the Committee on Economic Resiliency and Regional Relations. I've been really clear with you guys that as council president, I'm not going to be putting forward a change. You've chosen to continue to use your time to come down and testify, and that's great.
Never told us why you won't put forward a change.
Actually, I have in the other meetings, and I'm sorry you haven't been at those meetings. And today,
talk to us while we're here. If we're the ones
in these sessions,
the
this is about the agenda.
So,
I'm sorry that you haven't been a part of those other conversations, but I know that you could probably catch up with Sam and with Alex about those conversations.
Those conversations are usually you telling us that what we have to say is not on the agenda.
Actually, not in the other format. So you are past your time now.
So you can talk to them, but you can't talk to me.
At this point, I'm waiting to hear from them.
She represents Stand Up America.
When is the point you can talk to me?
At this point, Sam, your time is being taken up now.
That's not true.
Started yet? Yeah. All right. Yeah. She can't take my time. All right, so thank you. So my name is Sam Bellameo. I'm here with Stand Up America. And I want to continue the dialogue because on each agenda item, it was put forth by a committee. But that committee doesn't allow for open public dialogue. The same problem me was speaking about is that we don't have a chance. It's because you're letting me speak that I'm allowed to speak, but your rules don't say it. What we're putting forth isn't a tactic. We're not trying to debate you. We're talking about fundamental structures of how the government's working. This problem we have in the United States isn't in Alabama. It's not in New York. It's not in California. It's everywhere. It's here in Washington. There's something that failed. Like, you cannot, it's undeniable. Something failed in America. 150 million people are considered low income. It's not an economic problem. It's a government failure that allowed corporations to have that. But we can't bring that forth because you don't allow in your committees or in your full council for general open public dialogue on issues like I'm speaking about. I'm glad you're letting me speak because this proves that this is important and that I need to say it and that I'm here to say it. Now I want to encourage the public to come. I want to give them the place, the time, the space, something that's dependable, that they'll come and talk to you. You hold this during, just after lunch when people are going back to work, they can't get this time off to speak to you. And how are you going to fix it if you're just doing it from the bench? You're not even trying to outreach. You hold two town halls a year, and both of them are around the budget. So, of course, people are heated about the budget. They never come to talk about something else. They want to come and talk about a pothole that needs to be fixed or some paint that needs to be put on the roadway or some bike trail. And that's because it's important to them because they don't get the opportunity. But what things do they have to say besides that? You have no clue because you only wait until there's a hot topic and then hold a meeting. But what about those subtle little ideas that might spark and make a change that make Seattle more successful than any other city? You guys are the leaders. Start leading, doing something that's different than other cities, other towns. Make my voice count. And quit acting like this is just another day on the job. Thank you.
Thank you. Alex?
Hi, my name is Alex Zimmerman, and I represent Stand Up America. Stand Up America advocate for poor people, disabled people, senior citizen, student. We try protect and advocate for everybody who in less protective class. Guys, for last 30 years, you destroy everything. You destroy us republic, you destroy us constitution, you destroy us freedom of speech. We cannot come back to America what is we have for 200 years without fundamental change direction. For 30 years, you make ton of mistake every day. How we can change this? We need doing same what is doing every city in King Country right now. When mayor sit down together with council and listen to people every week, it's not happening here. You listen to us individually, mayor listen to us individually, mayor have a town hall, a pure propaganda for re-election, and nothing changed. 4 years we in recession, pardon, not in recession, in collapse. And everybody predict right now when we don't stop in this collapse, 4 years from now, few years from now, America probably will be same problem have like Soviet Empire before. We can chop by chop from different state to different state and make a 50 different republic. It's possibility when we don't make a changes. So situation very simple right now. Basic changes, doing everything what is every city in King Country doing right now. Mayor, with you, sit down every day, every week, and listen to people for 15-minute limit. It's okay. Start something doing. Without changes, fundamental changes, nothing will be held. You know what this mean? Crime go up, poor people go poorer, everything collapse. We need changes. Please, it's very simple.
Thank you, Alex.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Should note that we've been joined by Councilmember Richard Conlon.